Record button has been pressed. I should now say, hi guys, Todd here, vlog time, or catch up time, because I've not actually got that much to share with you. Well, when I say that, I mean in like drama or my lifestyle options or what product do I use to dye my hair? Nothing exciting like that, I'm afraid. What I can do is I can tell you what I have in front of me here just now that I will be reviewing in the near future, and hopefully what's coming my way to show off to you. Now, obviously it's kind of, what is it, the 11th of December. Things are kind of gone quietened off or tailed off, but there are still a fair bit going on. Obviously, mostly in the borrow scene, it's just never stops. Never stops. So what I'll do is we'll just crack on. I'm going to try and keep this as short as possible because I have to go and get changed and I have to go and start decorating. It's not fair, I tell you. It's not right. It's not just. It's not fair. Before I do, I shall have a vape from... Here's the thing. I'm still vaping away with this. The Chroma 217. Now, it's not often, and the Z-Force. Was that what it was called? Was it Z-Force? I can't remember. Yeah, Z-Force. The Z-Force tank. Which, as I said in the review, the coil is... It's still going. It's still... I mean, this is... I can't even see. I can't see. What can I say? I'm old. A lot of life. It's really good. There's no shame to this at all. Once again, the tank is very... It's a cloudy tank, but the mod is... I did the review. I didn't actually realise that this was kind of like a fill and dimmy type deal with Inikin. So, yes, well done, gentlemen. In that, I got some scones. I don't know if it depends. Oh, no, that bottle. That's the one I'm vaping with. Scones. How do you say it? I just say scone. Some people say schoon. It kind of depends what part of the world or part of the country you're from. But it's very, very nice. That's Dark Star. I've been enjoying their juices a lot. What else have I been vaping away with? Mostly I have been I had to put this away. I had to stop using it. The little Cthulhu AIO. Carrot Laboratories doors on it, which I will say, I as much as I really like these doors, I wish they were a bit thinner. I just wish they were a bit thinner because they do add a bit onto the device. That's just Alex. You probably will never see this, but yes, love the doors, great value for money. But the V2, the V2, they are. Getting rid of the AIO logo for sure, so that's good. I've been using my little Delro a lot, because if you have a red Delro, why wouldn't you use it? And that's pretty much mostly what I've been using outside the review stuff, if you like. Show you a couple of things that are supposedly coming along. Now, as I usually say, the way I work, or I've always worked in the review game, I do buy gear for review, but I'm lucky. I'm in a position where I don't really need to buy a lot of review gear because I get sent so much free to review. Yes, I'm the first person to hold my hand up and say I'm very, very lucky in that respect. I'll also say, if somebody says they're going to send me something, I may tell you, they may then go radio silent and decide they're not going to, but that's just one of the things that, that's just the way the game goes. And the fact that I'm not paying for it that's their prerogative. And these things happen. So, I may have said to you at earlier points in other videos that such and such a device is arriving for review and it may never turn up. It's just, that's it. However, here's something which will hopefully turn up very, very soon. Right. This is Ground Cloud Innovations. Probably know them. This is another Borrow Tank device, and it's called the Drop. And it's weird. It's that'll be my front door. It's very weird, because the reason I'm saying it's weird. Can we find another? There's a good photo I can show you. So you got your Borrow Tank in there. This is not flush with the body. This piece here and your firing button here, it actually sticks out. Sticks out. So I'm really curious what this is going to be like. It's very different. There we go. So that's hopefully on the way soon. Actually, I've just thought of another thing that I had to show you. Where can we go here? Is it Critival? Critival. I'm sure it's Critival Box. I'm in another Facebook group here. Now, where did they go? Right, the Crit Bot, I think they're calling it. Look at this. So the Crit Bot, it's an 18650 DNA 60. Another borrow device, which is incredibly similar to the EYN that I'm just about to show you from Elsa Garp. This is another one that's coming out. I don't have this coming for review, just to point that out. I don't have this coming for review. I just thought I would show it off to you because, why the hell not? Other things, this may be coming from Uncle Darren. I'm not 100% sure. I know there's a package on the way from Armor Mods. I'm not sure if this is in it or not. I really don't know. But this is, they're doing a little RBA for the Dot mod. And I believe it's direct lung, restricted direct lung. So, yeah. Once again, just reading on the side there, he posted 18 hours ago. A lot of testing and corrections been needed. We're almost there. So this might not be something I show you very soon, but you know it's on the way. So there we go. There's something else that's possibly coming my way for review. And this is something that, this is another borrow. Another borrow device. This is from Limelight Mechanics. I've forgotten what he's calling it. It's the wicket, it's the borrow wicket type device for people with large thumbs. Yeah, that might be what it's called. I don't know. It's Limelight, and look at that. Firing button here. Firing button there. You can change it. I think it's coming with two. I don't know if it's going to come with two faceplates, but you can certainly change it round. And knowing the main man himself, this will probably be down the line. You know, it'll come in the usual walnut and stab and all that kind of stuff. But the thing that I really, really like about this mod is that it looks nothing like a borrow mod. If that makes sense, it just looks like a wicket. Which is a good thing. I think it's coming in. I'm sure he said it's coming in about 83 millimeters in height. Now, yes, that one really interests me, because not only do I find the man sexually attractive, he does make exceedingly good gear. Choking. Right, so that's the things from the land of Facebook that I've seen that I think you may be interested in. As always, I'm just going to click on my Facebooky thing here and have a quick squiz through and see if anything else has come up. There's a new Delro coming soon. I know that much. There's a new Delro coming soon, so yes. Looking forward to that. Right, what have I got? Let's show you other gear. What I've mostly been vaping on since it arrived. And let's just change this camera to here. There we go. Excuse, it's covered in, it's probably covered in scratches and fingerprints. Is the BXR by Hisar. And I'm actually using a friendly flipper, EUC bridge inside here. Because I thought I would, I've always liked the EUC coils. My favourite is the 0.5 ceramic. Love that. Usually about 25 watts. And the coil lasts for ages. It really does. I found these in the drawer. I think they're 0.4s or something like that. But they're rated for like 40 to 60 watts. So I'm trying them. But the air that goes through them. Shh. Insane. So I'm actually vaping this at 36. It's recommended from 40 watts upwards, and I'm vaping it under, as usual. I'm pretty sure this isn't a ceramic. The ceramics are, the 0.5 ceramic is a benchmark coil for me. It really is. It's a benchmark coil. But I do like them. I do like the EUC coils. But anyway, that's not what I was talking about. The BXR is... I'm waiting on... there was a slight issue with mine when it arrived, was the battery cap. There was an issue with it. I'm waiting on a new one coming out before I can do the review. Matthias, if you see this, get your finger out, your bahoohy, and get it sent on ASAP. Please, because I'd really love to review this. Short and sweet version, I have no real issues to give you. The firing button is the... I love the firing button on this thing, I really do. And it is so, so comfortable. It's actually... it's not the smallest bottle mod by a long way, but because of this curved back here and the location of the firing button, it's... up there, one of my favourites. So there you go. Right. Whilst we're on bottle mods, I may as well show you this. I've just taken it to bits to give it a clean because I've been hammering away at this for the past couple of days because I want to get a review out for this soon. This is from L Sig Art in Athens, Greece. Now, once again, this is a bottle mod, and this is tiny. This is a small screen DNA 60. There's no USB port. Normally they come in black. This is, he's doing a white ones as well. There's actually a list, I think, up in the LSIG Art Facebook group just now. I think the black ones, I think, are 380 euros. I'm not sure what price the black one, the white ones are. Did I get that the right way around? Black, 380. I don't know what the whites are. Anyway. However, here we go. Let me find something. Just going to grab a billet box here. It's tiny. I think it's about 72 millimetres in height, which for... it's actually probably the shortest DNA 60 mod I have. It's so small. It really, really is. However, he's got a little bit of girth going on there because obviously the Boro tank is going in this way. So if I take this, stop biting my nails. Yeah, obviously the tank's going in this way. So it's going to be wider across here. So Firing buttons up here, small screen DNA 60, single 18650, no USB, and this has, this is, oh, and an adjustable positive pin down the bottom as well. You can adjust that height wise. This is kind of smart. This is, I really like this. I do really like this. Take the billet box out of the way. It's been, the strange thing is here, and I'll show you this back up here. Firing with it is, now I can fire it with there and with the fleshy part of my hand, but I've got to say that I'm actually finding it more comfortable in my left hand, because you know the firing button is right at the, you know, tip of my thumb, so it works out better. But it works well in both. It works well in both. I think he's done a really good job in this one. It's been performing well. Also, I will say, and I'll cover it in the review, the tank's going that way, but you can still fill your tank. I've been able to fill my standard borrowed tank, the KO, I can fill, and the bunker from Armor Mods. I can pull the windows down or open the tab and fill through the front, which is brilliant. So there we go, that's that. Other things, what else can I show you? Oh, show you this. I have been vaping away with this. This is, I'll take this off just now. This is the Raffi by AB Mods, which has, I got the other pins. Oh, excuse the drip tip. Oh, that's disgusting. Get that off there. Sorry. The Raffi by AB Mods. I'm pretty sure I read saying that he's thinking about making titanium ones. I still think the flavour from this is amongst the best I've had this year. The flavour is superb. He's got a full set of airflow pins for it now, so you can go proper mouth to lung to direct lung with this thing. Yeah. Good little bit of kit, this. Good little bit of kit. Go and check him out, Gus at AB Mods. Right. Let's give this thing a little show and tell now. This is something else that just came in. This is from... why am I always covered in juice? Always covered in juice. I could be in the Sahara Desert and they find my body and it'll be covered in custard. This is from Sirius Mods out of Turkey. This is the Quasar 75. And yeah, it's a single 18650 device. And it is an Evolve DNA 75. I've not seen a DNA 75 device in a very, very long time. But they decided to go with the 75 board. Which personally I find a bit strange, but I would have probably preferred a 60, but that's what they've went. So it's metal body, it's not zinc, I think it's an aluminium body, stainless steel buttons, their own 510 up the top. The battery door is actually excellent, it's very good. Spring loaded contact here, clicks into place no problem. And there'll be a review for this before Christmas, and it will be it'll be dry. There'll be no juice on it. I'll try my best not to have any juice on it by then. Actually, I'm reading Facebook here. Sorry, I shouldn't be looking at Facebook. Sorry, just a little bit distracted there for a second. I saw a car for sale that looked very nice. Must stop looking at cars. But that is everything that I have for you. What's in for review, what's coming for review, and I think that's it. Quick look about. Yeah. Album. little bit of Bowie. This was a present from my dad. This was my father getting rid of all his old vinyl that he didn't want anymore and dumping it on me. But brilliant. Brilliant. Just, sorry. Off in one there. Is there anything else exciting me that happened? I almost, my SVA, which I love. I absolutely love this device. They've got a door where they've got a window in the front there, and it's like €100 for the door. And I was, I see buying from abroad now that Brexit and all that crap. I think it was like almost €40 for delivery. That's €140. And then by the time it gets here from Italy, then there's probably going to be customs on top of that as well. That's for a door. Sorry, I know some people don't bat an eyelid about that kind of stuff, and I wouldn't think anything of it, but it's just a door for this mod. Which does make it look really, really... Actually, let's show you. Let's show you. SVA mod. Is that it? There we go. Screenshot. Right. I mean, look at that. I think he's got like forged carbon doors. And I mean, this was the door I was looking at. I'll probably give in and just buy it because I think it looks so much nicer than the standard one. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. Back. They're just they're gorgeous, but I mean it's a different land. I mean, you get a lot of people, and this I'm going off in one. I mean, this just goes to show you, everything's relative, and we all have our own budgets, and some people watch me. I get comments left in my videos when I do a review for something over £100, saying that that's ridiculous. Who would spend that kind of money? And some I've bought mods £400, £500, £600 and not thought anything of it because that's my hobby. But even that's not expensive. There's mods that are over £1,000, and it's all, you know, what I think's expensive might be dirt cheap to somebody else. So you should never care what somebody else is spending their money on. That's the best way of looking at it. But bloody Italians, Jesus, they know how to charge for stuff. I can't say that. Sorry, that's terrible. I shouldn't say that. I got that free to review. So that's just, I'm from Fife in Scotland. We like to moan about things because we're tight for some reason. It's a known fact. Anyway, put that back up there. That is all I have for you. I'm going to head off now, go and get changed, start decorating, and my life sucks. Anyway, I will have some reviews. I'm sorry there's not been much of anything going up. I really am sorry there's not. It's just got quiet, and I need to test stuff before I do a video for it. I can't. As much as I'd love to just put content up for stuff that's just come in the door, I really can't. There's a thing. Is the Vandy Vape AIO out? Is it the Vandy Vape Pulse AIO? Is coming soon? No current AI. There's no current ETA for it in the UK yet. It doesn't appeal to me, but I would probably like to show it off. I'm kind of curious about it. It depends on the price point. See, there's they're a drop shipper. I'm pretty sure DG Vape is a drop shipper. I could be wrong. If anybody knows DG Vape, they're saying they've got it in stock and it's £65. I'm not going to put the site up because I recommend them or anything like that, because I honestly do not know if they're drop shippers. That's the thing. I hate that. It doesn't say anywhere in the site that is, you know, they're a drop shipper. You could pay that £1.85 and end up having to wait 3-4 weeks for it. So anyway, but I'll probably grab one when they do come out, or when I can get one, just so I can have a go at it and see how I got on. Right, now I'm going to decorate. Thank you very, very much for your time. Thank you to everybody that has been watching the videos, and we shall catch up with you very, very soon. Have a lovely weekend. Bye for now.